of a white Christmas.
It turns out that the notion of a white Christmas has some interesting roots, at least partly in long-term climate changes. Now here's a look at the results of a bunch of studies that have tried to reconstruct average temperatures going back hundreds of years, focusing on the Northern Hemisphere. There's a lot of variation here. Looks a little bit like the spaghetti plots that we sometimes show you in 12-day trends. But if we average all these lines, there is the hint of a period starting around 1500 or so, when average temperatures were a degree or two lower than today. This cooler time is commonly called the Little Ice Age, and there's evidence that it made a noticeable difference in both Europe and America. For example, during that time in the Netherlands, canals frequently froze solid, while in the Swiss Alps, glaciers advanced and threatened villages. Winters were generally colder in England, too. There are accounts of the Thames River freezing over, something that never happens now, though that's only partly attributable to climate change. New York Harbor actually froze over during the winter of 1780, allowing people to walk from Manhattan to Staten Island. That winter was so harsh that the venerable American Philosophical Society in Philadelphia sent out a request for weather observations to document the brutal winter. Now, there's general agreement that the Little Ice Age ended in the middle of the 19th century, and it turns out that some of the most memorable Christmas stories were written just before it ended, during a time when people had a colder and most likely snowier impression of what the weather should be like this time of year. For example, Clement Moore published "Twas the Night Before Christmas" in New York in 1823, describing new fallen snow on Christmas Eve. This story is largely responsible for the modern American view of Santa Claus, including his appearance, his method of transport, and the number and names of his reindeer. About 20 years later, the classic "Over the River and Through the Woods" was written in Massachusetts to describe childhood memories of a Thanksgiving sleigh ride through the white and drifted snow. Around the same time, Charles Dickens wrote A Christmas Carol, where he described the bitter cold of London during the holidays, with the miserly Scrooge forbidding his clerk to put more coal on the fire. And a century later, Irving Berlin's classic lyrics in the biggest pop hit of all time stirred up memories of a snowy past by dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know. Now, here in Pennsylvania, the historical probability of a white Christmas varies from about 10% in Philadelphia to more than 70% in the higher elevations of the Northwest. In State College, it's about 4 in 10 winters. Fred's back with the extended forecast next.